I think more people should know about Fillout. This is a form and scheduling platform which I have fallen in love with. I've been using it for half a year now. I'm doing most of my forms in here, my full call scheduling, including payments. There are automations built in, and I'm still using the free version. So I think you should know about this because it can replace multiple WordPress plugins, but also your call scheduling platform that you're using right now. So many people, of course, use the Google Calendar scheduler, or of course, Calendly or TidyCal. And these are all great, but most of the actual useful features are hidden behind paywall. So let's start with the call scheduling one, connecting to Stripe or other automation platforms, email reminders before a meeting, different event types. And this is already amazing. Almost everything from Calendly, a paid standard plan, is free in Fillout. And then if you compare it to other form platforms, for example, WP Forms, which by the way is a great plugin, but if you want conditional logic, if you want fail uploads, form notifications, spam protection, multi-page forms, these are all pro features. And you have to pay per site. Let's check out another popular one, conditional logic. Spam protection, and if you want to connect it to other platforms, you have to go to an even higher plan. Again, most of this stuff is here for free in Fillout. So once I discovered this, I was like, wow, this is cool, but I'm first gonna test it before I make a video about it. But now after half a year, I can confidently say that this is an awesome platform, which makes my life easier. For example, I am doing my client questionnaire in here. So whenever a client wants to approach me, this is the form that I send them. It's fully hosted on their platform. I can customize the link if I want, which I haven't done. I now gather testimonials with Fillout, which I used to do in Google Forms. I used it to find people for my company. Oh, it's actually 8 months ago. And also for my client discovery meetings, which is actually connected to a payment. And you can create any type of form. You can see all the templates they have right here. And again, I am still on the free version. So let's open one of the forms and let me show you a little bit more. This is my client questionnaire. And to make this video special, I have also prepared a client questionnaire PDF for you that you can use if you don't have a client questionnaire right now. Because I think that more people should use a client questionnaire, because otherwise you're gonna get that awkward conversation in the beginning with a new client, which is like, hey, how much does the website cost? And then you're like, ah, well, that depends. And then they're like, well, it depends on what? And then it's kind of awkward. So if you have a form like this, where you ask specific questions, what is the goal of the website? Can you share competitors, development questions, design questions? Then you already have a much better starting point for that first conversation. And so I wanted to make it a little bit nicer for you. And so I have prepared a form that you can import, because when you make a form, you can also import an existing form from a PDF. So that's the one you can import, or you can even do one from Google Form or from Typeform. I've actually also used Typeform in the past, but they've become quite expensive. But I have to say, this platform also has a very beautiful UI. But yeah, Fillout is hard to beat. Let me just show you what I mean, okay? So here at the bottom, you have your multi-page. You can add all kinds of fields from here. It's just simple. Drag and drop, as you see, absolutely gorgeous menu. It is designed incredibly well, easy to use, and that's honestly all you need for forms. I mean, it doesn't have to be that complex, but of course you want to change the design a little bit, right? So they have this theme option. They have all kinds of themes, basic themes from here. But then inside of a theme, you can also customize it to your colors. You can choose the font, which then opens Google Fonts, which is nice. And there's even an advanced designer where you have a little bit more options. But honestly, I've never actually used it because the default design is already very pretty. But there are some themes available where you can set up a background, etc. And it also really depends on how you're going to use it, right? Like this form, I've just published it under a link, but you can also embed it in your website, or put it in a pop-up, and then they give you a button, you can change the color, and then it opens in a pop-up on your website, right? So it really depends how you want to use this. But yeah, that's just the editing experience. You could just add your questions here. And then they also have conditional logic. So for example, right here, I have a question. What is your estimated budget for this project? And if they click on this option, then this heading shows up. And this is just an example, by the way. I could probably do a better job with the copyright here, but I want to show dynamic visibility is built in. So here, edit the conditional logic. You can select the fields equals to, and then one of the options. And so you can build very smart dynamic forms. And then the integrations. This is awesome as well. And almost all of the other platforms have this as a paid feature. So what happens when somebody fills out this form? It automatically creates a Google Doc in my Google Drive that you can also set up smartly. So here's my folder, and then here is the file name. So it will say client, then a dynamic field, the email, and then the submission ID, which I needed because I also built an automation with this one. Because when this form is submitted, then ChatGPT is going to analyze all of the information in there and then starts drafting an email reply. It's really cool what you can do these days with automation, but that's for another video. I just wanted to show that you can set up how it shows up in your Google Drive, and it also automatically sends me a Slack message when somebody fills out the form, so I know that something happens. And then you could also set up a webhook to connect it to other platforms, like an automation platform. There are some of them built in, like Zapier or Make. I've also been really liking AutoKit, so that's possible if you use the webhook. Some other things that people might use here as well. I really like Notion. So one database in Notion would be nice, but there's also already a database built in, so you don't really have to connect it to a Google Sheets or a Notion. So if you go to the results, you can see that you have a little table here as well. What's also really nice is the default options in here. So when somebody fills out the form, you can send yourself an email and another person in your company, if that's relevant. The person that filled out the form will get an email with a link to edit the submission if you want. You can set up a thank you email or an email after a day. URL parameters are also built in, if you know what that means. Start date, end date, language of the form. You can even turn it into a quiz. I haven't done that. There's also a ton of different input fields, which again are paid features on other platforms, like a signature, file uploader, even a voice recorder. I've used this one when I was trying to find people for my company. I just added this input field in there and just say like, hey, why do you want to work for me? And then I could hear their voice. And that helped me so much because, you know, in a text box, people can type whatever they want. They could use ChatGPT, right? But a voice, you cannot really fake. I mean, these days you can, but... It did work for me. What else? Yeah, there's already anti-spam built in, so you don't have to find an anti-spam plugin and install that on your WordPress website, and you never really know which one is good. Here it's just already built in. Oh, you can add a video in there. So let's say that you want to have a video as an introduction. You have a video on your YouTube that says something about the form. You can add a progress bar as well at the top. Okay, then let's talk a little bit about the Calendly call booking system. So as you can see right now, I have a few forms, for example, this one. This one I just also use via the link. I just sent this link to people, or you can just link it on your website. It's automatically connected to my Google Meet. So whenever somebody fills it out, it shows up in my calendar. You can set up your global working hours. Most platforms have that. There's a bunch of options here, but a nice one is here that the person who filled this out will automatically get an email 1 hour before. It's incredibly nice, incredibly beautiful, as you can see. Yeah, this one I've also connected to my Slack and the Google Calendar. And here I have set up an automation that doesn't approve or reject, because this is a call that I don't always want to do. And so I will get an email from Fillout saying like, hey, do you want to have this meeting? Yes or no? And then there's an approve button. So then on the final page, you see something like this. And if you still need to accept a meeting, then you can click on approve or reject. And since it's connected to my Stripe, the payments will automatically come through. And after the payment, you can automatically send them the Stripe receipts. I mean, come on. This is just great. You can do one-time subscriptions and pay what you want. This is actually a pretty nice feature. I tried to do this years ago on WordPress, and it was so hard because it's not a functionality that was built into WooCommerce. But now if a client asks for this functionality, I can just make them a form connected to their Stripe, and then it's done. And talking about clients, let's talk about clients, because you can just connect your clients to your account. These are separate organizations, so each organization has their own forms and call scheduling. You can separate them in folders if you want. If you don't do that, they will just stick to your homepage, I think. And then if the day comes that your client says like, hey, we don't want to work with you anymore, you can just remove yourself from that organization. So you can manage all of your client forms make a user for them as well. Again, all for free because seats are not a paid feature. So that allows you to just add your client. Here, adding users is free. So yeah, I hope you can see that this is quite an awesome platform. There are, of course, also some downsides of using the free version. For example, you do see the logo with the free version in some places. For example, at the end of the form or at the bottom of the emails. There is a limit of 1,000 responses per month, but you know, for most businesses, that is enough. There is no redirect on completion. That's part of the pro. There are some fields limited in the free version. I have not run into any issues, but they have more PDF viewer, location, coordinates, captcha, and signature, a custom domain if you want. And there are, of course, also limitations in using a platform like this, which is not a WordPress plugin. So let's say that you want to connect things to custom post types, or you want to save information in WordPress and then use that later. You cannot do that. So it's not always the best option to use this. I understand. I'm just super excited about this platform. I think people should know about it. So I hope that this can save some of you some money. I do think that's the case, especially with the call scheduling. Yeah, that's basically all I wanted to say. I am working on another more advanced video, like I said, where I'm connecting the responses to the form to a ChatGPT. That will be uploaded later. For now, I just want to thank you for watching, and I hope that you enjoyed this video.